In this healthcare basics video, we're going to cover the patient track manager, which lets us define how the patients and staff members behave within your model. Everything a patient does in the model, from the time they enter to the time they leave, is dictated by a patient track, so it's an extremely important part of your healthcare simulation project. To create a new patient track, click the Patient Tracks button on the toolbar, and then Add a Patient Track. Alternatively, you could go to the toolbox, click Add New Tool, and then Patient Track. If you right-click your new track in the toolbox, you can rename it, a good idea if you need to keep up with multiple tracks. You can also duplicate a track and all the activities inside it. Your new track will open up in the Patient Track Manager, where you will add, edit, and manage the various activities in each track. If you have more than one track open in the manager, they will each have a tab at the top so you can quickly swap between them while working. The toolbar just underneath has buttons to add, delete, and position activities within the patient track. The toolbar also has the table view, which provides a high-level overview of the settings for each activity. In the middle is the activity list, which houses all the activities that have been created for this track. We only have time to cover the basics here, so you might want to read the chapter called Patient-Centered Activities in the user manual for a deeper explanation of this tool. Here are the steps for populating the track. You add an activity, choose the type of activity it will be, and then edit the applicable parameters for the chosen activity type, and change any advanced settings if needed. Let's go through a very quick and simple patient track example. Create a basic model with a patient arrival, a patient processing location in the form of a registration desk, and a patient exit, with a receptionist staff group to handle registration. Open the flowchart and connect these objects so that patients arrive, go to registration, and then exit. We will have three activities in our example, so add two more. By default, each activity will have an ID followed by an underscore. The ID can be changed in the quick properties to be any whole number you'd like. This ID is used to refer to this activity in other activities, which we'll get to in a bit. When you name the activity, the ID and underscore are required before the name or label that will help you recognize the activity. Activities can also have milestones, which mark the beginning and end of specific periods of time and are useful for data gathering. They can also make naming activities much faster. If you select a milestone before assigning a name to an activity, that activity will automatically be named based on the milestone. We'll focus on the basic settings for the arrival activity first, so choose arrival for its milestone. The topmost option in the quick properties is activity type. The most important part of creating a new activity is choosing what activity type it will be. The activity type affects how the patient will interact with staff and resources within the healthcare facility. Notice how the first activity has patient travels unattended by default. We won't need to change this activity type because we want our patient to travel unattended to the registration desk when they arrive. This type has patients travel to a destination without the help of staff members, so we'll need to specify that destination. We'll use the patient destination drop-down list to tell our patient where they need to walk during this activity. In this case, we want our patient to go to the registration desk. You can use Choose a Specific Destination to select the registration area, or just click the sampler, and then click the registration desk in the model. Select Registration is the milestone for our second activity. The registration activity needs to have the process activity type, because registration represents a process delay in the patient's care. We'll need a process time to represent how long registration takes, and again, there are many options to cover a variety of scenarios. Because the registration process might take longer for some patients than others, let's choose a basic statistical distribution to add some real-life variance to the model. We'll need to specify which staff members are required for the process. Add a staff requirement using the green plus sign, and use the sampler to choose any member from receptionists. Finally, the departure activity should be similar to arrival, except the destination will be patient exit area, which represents the patient exiting the facility. Let's see these activities in action. If you click reset to reset the model and run to run the simulation, you'll see patients arrive, walk to registration, complete the registration process, and then leave, just as we planned. Again, we're just scratching the surface of what you can do with patient tracks. Please read our user manual for more detailed information. Thank you for watching. Tune into the next video to learn about patient arrivals and PCIs.